did as... has actually a little bit of what we did with the HMX and a little bit of what we did with the acoustic guitar.
And then
because I had to create a situation that had a bit of, you can make it a bit richer, like the HMX. You can make it a standout, like the acoustic ACG. But also I had to make sure that it, there were some compression networks in there that really worked with, say, heavy guitar. Or already distorted things. So there's no distortion in this, although there is a bit of that. It's assuming that you're coming to the table with the sound that you've got, with a well-recorded sound, and you're just going to add some stuff to it. But let me mess with this a little bit. This electric guitar, unfortunately, I can't demonstrate the heavier bit because it's a cleaner rhythm part. So let me solo this. Turn off our automation.
So I start getting
comedy stuff.
So
let me see if I can find a spot. Oh, that's all he's kind of doing. I'm gonna leave this one off. You guys can try it yourselves. This guitar part is just it's not gonna demonstrate anything. It's just a little fluff part. So forget that one. I'll let you have a look at it. In the same way that the other plugins, the different modes will allow you to affect different things. The clean setting is probably closer to that acoustic guitar thing that we had. Rhythm will work for a more choral rhythm part that you want a bit of room on. The heavy part is really, most of that is in the compression network, a little bit of equalization, and some slight effects to sort of broaden it and enrich it so that you can take something that's already heavy and just make it fill the whole spectrum a lot more.